By the way, crazy situation. Zurdo just told me that he signed the contract to fight Bivol, but he hasn't heard back from the other side yet. Yeah. That's crazy.
I mean, it is, but it isn't. Like, look, like we wanted that fight, but obviously they waited. They were waiting to see what happened with Canelo and Plant, and if Canelo has endeavors at 175, they hold power with the belt. So why would they risk it with Gilberto? You know, I mean, like as much as it sucks for us, I also understand. You know, there's politics in this, and that's why a lot of people don't understand. Like people are like, oh, why doesn't he fight this? Why doesn't he fight that? Like, well, man, like there's a lot of politics in boxing.
It sucks because we want to see Zurdo. But I told Zurdo, listen, you're 42-0, 28 knockouts. You just need a fight.
Yeah.
You can fight you. You just need a fight. You can't wait for these guys.
Yeah. We're not going to wait. We're not going to wait. Whatever shows up next, we're going to be ready. It could be anyone, you know. Zurdo's at a place mentally and physically in his prime. So whoever they want to put in front of us, we'll take the fight, you know. I'm confident.
So, Julian, what do you think Canelo does next if you were a guessing man?
I think he's going to go to 75, and I think the easiest fight for him to make is Bivol because...
Joe Smith.
But that's top rank, right?
Why not? I mean, he's a free agent. He's a free agent. You like Joe Smith fight?
He's the most dangerous dude at that weight class.
Joe Smith?
Not the most dangerous, but he's...
Most dangerous dude in that weight class is here somewhere roaming. Where did Zurdo go? AJ. He's the most dangerous guy.
He's not the most dangerous guy, but he's not a big name, and he's quite a risk.
And I think he has a great...
You're a great promoter. You must be friends with him.
He has a great relationship with... He's a great relationship with Eddie Hearn.
That's true.
I think like that would be like the next step. You know, Canelo's never fought under the top ranked banner.
Yeah.
And I think he's only gonna go for belts now. You know, I don't... As much as I'd love to see him fight David Benavidez at 168, there isn't really anything there for him when it comes to like legacy. So I think he is gonna move up to 175, and I think he's gonna fight. He'll probably fight Dimitri Bivol next, just to secure a belt at 75. Then probably try to go through the champions there.
Unify.
Yeah.
All right, let's see what happens. But
that's the most logical business scenario I see for him.
Him and Zurdo, do you like the fight?
I actually like what Steve Kim said, though. Steve Kim had a podcast, and he said he should join the commission. He should become a commissioner and force Bivol and Zurdo to fight. Force Charlo and David to fight. Basically have a tournament. Let these guys all eliminate each other, and then give the winner of this tournament kind of like the chance to fight him. I love that.
I'm going to tell you why I don't like it.
Why not?
Because things in boxing change all the time.
Yeah.
Delays. You have a tournament. It's too many variables.
Not necessarily and then, like a tournament. Not like the Ali trophy style. But I'm saying like just an elimination. You know, like Zurdo fights Bivol. And Archer Bitterbeev fights Joe Smith. And like, you know, let these guys eliminate each other. The winner of this little like thing gets a chance to fight him for the money.
But here's the problem. Canelo wants to fight in May.
Yeah.
So basically you're building a tournament with a guy waiting. You know, like it's...
Yeah.
That's... If they fought each other, makes sense. But when you have someone on the sideline, he has to be active.
Two of them can fight before May. You could have two rounds of the tournament gone. Have a fight in December, have a fight in February, and then the winner gets Canelo in May.
December's too soon to make it happen. It's a month away.
December? No. I said one in February.
I got
one
it.
In December, like December, like end of December.
It would have to be both in February in order to make it for May.
Is Canelo light heavyweight yet, though?
Canelo's everything. He could go up to heavyweight. He could beat Usyk. He could beat.
Usyk is a lot.
He could beat Fury.
Usyk Canelo for heavyweight.
Canelo spars Frank Sanchez, who's a huge heavyweight.
Yeah.
And he
but
does
Usyk
really good.
Different.
Okay, how about him and Fury? You like that?
Yeah, I like that kid, but Fury's huge, dude. 270.
They just said he has a messed up elbow. His dad said it today that he had a
Fury.
And Brandon Rios had that injury. That could be very, very bad for your career. Because if you have bone fragments in there, Brandon never recovered from that. And he had that from before the Pacquiao fight. So it's bad. But Zurdo, he's training, whether he has a fight or not.
Yeah.
You're training.
Stay
what's
ready.
Have to.
Yeah.
I saw Joel Diaz Jr. in the house.
Yeah.
Joel! I was watching him. I thought Danny Garcia was here. You look like Danny in there. Last time I saw him, we were with Broner in Miami.
Oh, yeah?
How you been?
Very good.
Shit, you look like a giant sparring. Now you're looking like yourself again.
I'm sending cross feet, you know?
What's next for you?
I would put
You have a fight coming up?
No, just for August
20th. And coming?
Yeah.
But you're good. No, you're good. You're working. Is this your gym now?
No, just come over here, boy.
He's welcome here whenever he wants.
He's a great person. I've known him forever. He's a badass. You have a lot of power.
It's all love, baby. It's all love. Excuse me.
Get back to work. Just saying hello. You signed with anyone yet?
The manager, Ryan Roach.
Who's it? Ryan Roach? Who's he with?
Huh? My manager right now. He's got Fighter Locker.
Okay.
Yeah, his manager.
But you're not with a promoter, right?
Not at the moment.
Not yet.
No, I've had promoters. Not signed.
21-1 is a great record.
Yeah, it's all right.
It's good. Hey, he picked Plan to win, and he told me right now, I will never doubt Canelo again.
Yeah, you can't.
Why would you doubt him in the first place?
I didn't doubt him. I just, you know.
Let's go back to watch the tape. Tailor the tape.
I did doubt him. I did doubt him.
Nah, listen. It's your opinion, and everybody in boxing is entitled to what they see. You know, in the end, we don't know what's going to happen until they step in the ring, right?
Yeah. The odds are the odds for a reason most of the time.
Yeah.
That's what makes this game so exciting, though. That's what makes this game so exciting. Is like, no matter what it looks like on paper, it's a fight.
That's true. So, November 20th, Crawford Porter.
I think Crawford. My heart's with Sean. I know Sean. I like Sean a lot. He's a good guy, and I would want him to win, actually. You know, but Crawford, I think, is one of the best in the world right now, and
talented.
And Sean has come up short in when it came to like some more like the higher level fights, and I think Crawford is actually the best fighter he's faced to date.
No, he fought Earl Spence.
I know.
And he fought Adrian Broner.
I know.
And he fought Crawford Kell Brook was good. This Kell Brook right now is not.
I think Crawford is still better than all of them.
So you're leaning towards Crawford?
Yes.
Did you ever face Crawford? You ever in a camp with a fighter faced him? Beltran fought him.
Yeah, I sparred with Ray a little bit for that fight for Crawford.
Crawford's a switch hitter. He's tricky.
But he's versatile and masterful. You don't see both at the same time.
And
he fights just as well right-handed as he does left. Can fight on the inside just as well as he fights on the outside.
Has a lot of knockout.
He has power. He has speed. He's got a chin. He's got good defense. Like he's not missing anything. He's complete. He's a complete fighter.
But he also has a wrestling background, which is very important.
So when he gets on the inside in these clinches where it's getting, it's not like he has trouble.
No, that's true. What's next for you, Bai? Your next fight?
Arnold Gonzalez. He fought last week.
How'd he do?
He won by knockout.
And I saw Scrappy's fight. I watched it.
Yeah. He beat that guy up. And then Arnold's again in 2 weeks.
Nice.
Yeah, in Ecuador for a small, like a South American title.
That's awesome. Have you ever been to Ecuador?
Yeah, I've been like 4 times.
No
we
way.
Fought over there. Yeah.
How'd you end up there?
Arnold.
He's from there?
Yeah. He's Ecuadorian.
How far is the flight? How long does it take?
It goes to Miami first, like 5 hours, and then 3 hours to...
Not too bad.
Yeah, it's not bad.
What's Ecuador like?
It's nice. I really like it. Everybody is very hospitable, you know. Arnold has a name out there, and I trained him. So
he's popular.
Like, yeah, and everybody will, you know, they know who we are over there, and everybody is very nice to us.
Do they have a boxing culture? Is it popular?
I don't think it's like the most popular
soccer
is, but still doesn't change the fact that like they pay attention to like the guys who are coming up.
Everybody loves a winner.
Exactly.
And he's doing good. I didn't know he was Ecuadorian. I thought he was Mexican.
Nah, he's Ecuadorian. Yeah.
Did you know that Arnold's Ecuadorian? Where is that? Where have I been?
Where is what?
I thought he was Arnold Gonzalez.
Where have you been?
Yeah. But he's a great kid. He's a hard worker.
Yeah.
And he
yeah.
will be a champion.
Yeah, for sure.
So what's up, Joel? How you been? Are you still breeding bulldogs? Were you breeding bulldogs at some point? I thought you were breeding bulldogs. Were you?
No, I have one, but
nah. One time, this girl that I know wanted to get a bulldog for adoption, and he was gonna take it.
Oh yeah.
I have a bulldog. Just a male. It's pretty nice, brown and white, but I haven't hooked him up with no business lately.
But it's coming. These are your drills, the Ukrainian boxing drills. What are they working on?
But just like he's just getting them to position his feet better, and that's what it looks like right now. You know.
Canelo did a beautiful job of that.
Oh, yeah. Only until he has so much experience. He's fought Floyd, he's fought Lara, he fought Billy Joe, he's fought
Trout.
Lateral movement, Trout, exactly. He knows how to like, he knows how to take advantage of when you have too much weight on one leg and you can't shift the other way. And he knows when you have too much weight on one leg and you're forced to shift the other way. So he'll meet you with a shot, you know? He's a very intelligent fighter.
He just did it in style. And I thought, honestly, Plant did great. Really impressed.
Yeah. I knew he would. He's a talented fighter. But you know, with Plant, like the tricks he uses to hit most guys with, he was still tricking Canelo with his jab, but like the tricking with the left uppercut, tricking with the right hand and stuff. You're not. He's Canelo's another level. The guys.
He's not falling. He's not falling for that.
Yeah. Well, the guys he hit with before, they don't have that like defensive anticipation. Like,
this weekend, who you got?
Who's this weekend? I've been.
You have two major fights this weekend. You have Rosado and Munguia, and you have Benavidez and Davis.
Oh, Benavidez.
What
sure.
round?
The guy's tough. He went to draw with Durrell.
Yeah,
I mean, I've never watched him. I can't never make a guess if I haven't watched a guy.
16-1.
Yeah, but I mean, I can still, even on paper, I can't, unless, yeah. to make a real educated
you
guess.
You have to study him.
But I just know Benavidez is a monster, and I think he's going to stop him.
Okay.
And then, who's the other one?
Munguia and Rosado.
I like Gabe. You know, my heart's with Gabe. He's a good dude. And he showed he can, you get a little overly aggressive and reckless, they'll catch you coming in, you know? And Jaime has a tendency to sometimes when he starts getting frustrated to get overly aggressive.
37-0, 30 knockout. So yeah. I mean, that's still sure. like he's learning. He's only 24, right?
Yeah. But so that's a lot of fights. That's a lot of experience. He's
a lot
still
of
learning,
knockouts.
But he's got a lot of fights. Yeah.
It's gonna be interesting. Are you going? Are you gonna go?
No. I've had fights literally every weekend
you
the last 5 weeks.
Wait till you get a family. Wait till you have some kids.
I know. I'll take a lot more breaks when that happens. Bro.
That's what you say now. Bro. Life, you can have so many fighters, so many champions. It's hard when you're in camp. Hey,
I hope so. God.
Let's ask Brian. Sorry, you have kids, right?
Yeah.
How did you do when you were fighting for titles and still have a family? Were you home a lot, or when you're in camp?
No, I was in camp, but there was a lot of sacrifice with my wife, with my family. You try to pick up, you know, my absence. You know what I mean? So it was tough, but it's cut, you know, part of the game. 2 months, 6 to 8 weeks.
I was telling Julian, who's busy right now, crazy, but I say, when you start having championship fights and you have a wife and a kid, it's going to get even more.
Yeah, crazy. So you're married into it.
Hopefully you get some kids, you get a family.
Yeah, yeah. I definitely want them, you know?
Yeah.
In this day and age, a lot of people are like, oh, I don't have kids. I'm like, no, man.
Don't wait, just do it. Figure it out later.
I don't know about that.
Just do it.
I feel like you should be ready. You should be a little ready, but
I don't think you're ever ready. Because if you're ready, you wait one more year. Let me have more money. Let me have a bigger house.
So for me, like right now, I feel like I'm ready. Like I could have a kid now, but 2 years ago, no.
All right.
You know, like, so I know there's never a time to be completely ready, but I feel good now.
That's true. I just don't want you to end up one of those coaches that at 7 years old, oh man, I should have, would have. Because you're so.
I don't live with regrets.
Yeah.
There's probably one major regret in my life, and I'm trying to still fix that problem today. So.
And that's it. That's great.
Yeah.
But you learn from experience.
Yeah, for sure. For sure.
And I think what you're doing with Zurdo is amazing. What you do with Zepeda is amazing.
Thank
so
you,
you're having
you.
A great, great year.
Yeah.
And they're starting to give you recognition, like on ESPN. Wait a couple more years and.
I'm not rushing anything. I'll take it when it comes. I don't want any handouts. I don't want any freebies. I want the work to speak for itself.
And you've been grinding for a long time now. There's nothing new. I've been seeing you for years.
Yeah. My parents made me that way. It's the only way I know how to be. My brother's in medical school. My sister's like one of the best graphic designers in LA. So our family strives for, you know, success. We know how important hard work is.
AJ, you know what's missing at your gym here? A big blackboard. Tell him why. Tell him why. They don't know about that?
I don't know if he knows.
You know he's an artist.
Like I used to do, like, yeah.
He used to draw Pacquiao, Ali. He used to do all that.
Yeah.
Walk in the gym, he would put like a saying and a.
Yeah.
It's not easy.
Quotes and stuff like that. Yeah.
I remember. Mike Tyson.
That's one of my favorite things to do for sure. I actually need to get back to that. I haven't made a picture of him in a while.
You should put it in canvas.
Yeah. Everyone tells me that. Get it and sell it.
Well, slowly. Do it for fun. And if it's good, people will pay for it.
Yeah.
But it's awesome. So hopefully Zurdo fights Bivol, but if not, anybody. Yeah. Just stay busy. Stay busy. I want him to get to 51-0.
Me too.
I think that would be awesome.
Me too.
And that's not easy.
Yeah.
It's 9 fights.
Yeah.
But you know what I like about the gym? That you could be the biggest name here or the smallest name here, and everybody work with everybody. Hollywood, like, you're not.
We don't allow it here. That's the thing about Brick House. Like, everyone understands, like, what vibes are. And if you have a shitty one, you're not welcome. You know? And it, like, that's what, I mean, Ryo was talking about it, you know, he was like, that's what I love about this gym, nobody's like
no drama,
like, you know, like,
nobody's stealing other fighters, other coaches' fighters.
Exactly, and then this too is like, what's it called?
It's a team effort.
Yeah, exactly, and when it's time to work, everybody goes at it, you know, it's not like, it's good vibes and everybody's lazy, you know?
Where's Crappy?
He's resting. He just fought, so he's just taking a day or two. But he'll be back in the gym probably tomorrow.
That was a great fight.
He played.
I like the experience. I like he was poised.
He's growing
maturing.
As a fighter. He's growing as a fighter, and you know, I respect the way that they, like, Loma did his career. It's very ballsy, but just amateurs is different than professional. You know, like, for instance, like Andre Durrell, right? He was a stellar amateur. But Anthony was the one who ended up becoming a world champion. So it's very different, you know, like, some guys are a slow burn. They need a lot of experience before they step up as a professional. And some people can just do it kind of right away. So you got to know your fighters. You got to know your guys and see where they're at. I think Scrappy's definitely ready for a televised show fight. He showed me his last fight, how he can be relaxed and poised, and he doesn't have to rush to get a guy out of there. He can take his time. You know?
No, I liked it, and I liked it. In the end, he got into it with the local guy, and the guy gave him a finger.
Yeah,
so Scrappy gave him the finger inside the glove.
Yeah, hilarious.
He's a funny.
And then the guy came after and actually was like, "Hey, you're a badass fighter," and he took a picture. He wanted a picture with Scrappy. And
nice.
I mean, you know,
emotions run high in the end of a fight.
And at the end of the day, it's a fight. This guy's not your friend. I understand this is a sportsman game, but it's a fight. Don't be mad when a guy doesn't want to touch gloves necessarily. Like, this is a fight, you know? Like, at the end of the day, he's not going to take care of your family. At the end of the day, he's not going to pay your bills. You know what I mean? You're paying your bills. So if you don't want, if that's how it is, you know? I'm all for sportsmanship, man.
Yeah, no, it's a business. It's the hurt game, and you want to win, and they want to win. If you're going to try to knock them out, they're going to try to knock you out.
Yeah, exactly.
But still, after a fight, you can squash everything.
100%.
I don't like when fighters take selfie with each other. I don't like that before a fight.
Oh, yeah,
don't be too friendly.
Yeah,
like Usyk and Joshua.
100%.
Joshua's a great person.
Yeah.
But he should not have done that.
Yeah.
Because psychologically, you're like, oh, I don't want to hurt this guy. He's cool.
Exactly.
Boxing's very psychological, too. But it's cool. Listen, what did they say in the movie Field of Dreams? If you build it, they will come.
Yeah.
And like, no one knew this gym would be this successful in the beginning. Now the gym, everybody's sparring here, sparring there.
We open, Benavidez is here, Zurdo's here, Zepeda's here, you know, Vittori, UFC fighters, Vittori, Giga, Urosh.
Brian Valoria's here.
Yeah, exactly.
Carlos, 3-0 from Houston.
4-0.
You ever sparred with Charlo's? But you know who they are.
Yeah.
How does Charlo do with Canelo?
I think you give him a good fight. He's the best one right now, besides the...
What do you think?
Benavidez.
Jamal and Canelo, what do you think?
Am I down in Canelo? Canelo, baby!
I mean, he's a 60-pounder, though. He's a 160-pounder. And
Charlo got to fight one trade, or he got to fight Keith Lee, and he makes up the 160.
After his last fight, too, I think he gets stopped by Canelo.
168 Canelo. Canelo's still 168. That was my contact number.
Anthony Durrell with that bolo shot. When was the last time you saw a bolo shot?
I mean, it was timed beautifully too. Like that was timed beautifully. Little slip came underneath.
Well, he wants Canelo next. What do you think?
After winning that one, like that wasn't like a big fight, you know? I mean, I know the kid, he fought on the contender and stuff, but he didn't win the contender.
Hernandez.
Like, you have to, even though it's a good performance, you have to fight somebody that's like, to get a chance to fight him. You know what I mean? Like, you know, like if BIVOL fights us, the winner of that, that's a deserving fight.
Okay.
Like Canelo Alvarez, you know what I mean?
What are the chances of him on BIVOL happening?
It'll happen.
ZURDO. Hopefully it does. Oscar De La Hoya said he's working on it.
Like I said, I understand both sides.
Yeah. Watch out, ZURDO. He hits hard. Hey. So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach.